Hey guys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag. It is about 3 in the afternoon on July the 30th, I think. And I have been hurting, so I pulled my back out while I was out here working on the car on 4th of July weekend, you know, that long weekend where I was posting all the videos. By that Monday, Tuesday, I couldn't move. So I've been laid up and unable to work on the car for a long time. So I'm actually just getting out in the garage today to try and fiddle around with a couple things. I did one thing last weekend. I actually came out here and I removed the patch I had installed on the door frame in this location. You might remember, you see the little tear. And I had put a cover patch over the top, and what I've done is installed that patch on the inside so that this window flange can go down by the thickness of that patch, which was actually, as it turned out, noticeable and enough to help me get a better fit on my window. So I took all the shims out of here, here, and the patch, which was acting like a shim here, and then I screwed it back in, and it's a lot better in terms of height. So I'll show you. Milo was here and he said, you know, the same thing Ray said, that Ray at Livingston, my other friend, said that top bar has to go down, and the only way to get it to go down was to refit the way the chrome frame fits into the door frame itself. I've removed the seal, lip seal along the back of the door, the back of the window channel, and you can see that I can get the door to close pretty, I get the first click without really pushing hard. Second click doesn't happen quite right. And you can see I've got a little bit of an offset here. That should go in and be flush. But since it's not closed all the way, I can't be too obsessive about it. But it's sort of not parallel either. So I'm kind of working on that a little bit today. I was thinking I might just move the bracket down in the bottom of the door back a little to cause this entire frame assembly to tip in this angle a little bit, just to give it a little more of an inward tilt. So I think I'm going to work on that this afternoon. That's kind of why I brought my stool over here and thought I'd turn on the camera. So we'll take a look at what we can get done fooling around with that adjustment. You know, at this angle, I don't know that there's any guideline. You know, does it need to be parallel to the inside of that door flange? Kind of looks like it is to me, but maybe a little inward lean would be helpful. So I'll bring you back when I get something done. Okay, guys, John Kerry coming back at you now. What I've done is a couple things, actually. I adjusted the chrome frame in the door frame a little bit to tilt it in. I adjusted the door latch lock mechanism on the B post a little bit so that the door would close tightly onto its second latch on the door lock with kind of as far in as I can get it to go with the current seal. It's a little proud of the bodywork, but not much, you know, just ever so slightly proud. I also loosened the hinge and I raised the door in this direction up just a hair to get that body line ever so slightly more intimate. And then I loosened the quarter window latch and slid the actual frame down in the hinge a little bit and then reattached the latch. So I have a better alignment between the two chrome lines you see here. They're not quite even, but they're real close, a lot closer than they were. So I'm happy with that. And I can actually get the door to close. I got to give it a little bit of a push, but it's not anywhere as bad as it was. So that looks like progress to me. And you can see the chrome now is pretty parallel from top to bottom. And that's one of the things that I'm personally a little, you know, kind of hooked on, wanting to make sure that that looks straight and that it's flat. It's not quite latched in all the way. You can see the door sticks out a little more proud here than it does down here. So, but yeah, it still sticks out a little bit there. I could probably get that latch to close a little tighter, but right now these seals are brand new and they're just not letting the door close more tightly than that. So I'm going to live with that for a little while and let the seal kind of bed in. But I think we've got to start. That's a good progress. And then the battery charger's working, guys. I put a voltmeter on it. Somebody told me disconnect the negative or the positive cable. I took the positive cable off the battery, put my little charger on it, and it's actually bringing it up. It's got a little over 12 volts on it right now. So I'm waiting for the LED to turn green, which is when the battery minder, battery tender, says that it's happy. Can't really read that, can you? It's too bright out the back. Amazing, your eyes are so much better than a camera. Battery tender junior automatic battery charger. Automatico. Cargador de baterías. Charger for batteries. Cool. I also put some fluid in my front brake reservoir, and I was gravity bleeding this front caliper over here, which worked. So I've actually opened up the one on this side over here, and I'm kind of waiting for that one to dribble a little fluid. So I'm kind of letting the gravity do a little bit of the work for me so I don't get carried away banging away on this. But I was able to get all that stuff back in and hooked up again. I went and bought myself a set of Harbor Freight flare nut wrenches, so I've got a cheap set. I wanted a nicer set, but I just couldn't get them. No place, none of the Sears stores had the Craftsman in stock, and I wasn't ready to pay $25 a wrench, so I got a set from Harbor Freight, $12 for a set of six. Crazy but true. All right, so I'm going to take a look at this one now and see if I can do some of the same tricks I did to the other one to bring this door in better alignment and allow it to close a little easier. So that's about it, guys. I'm going to give you one other little view into my interior here. I put this little A-post cover in place. It's got a little pucker in it. I'm not real happy about that pucker. I'm going to try and pull that out and get that to come flat. I got to loosen these screws, maybe open up the holes a little bit and give myself a little adjustment room. But anyway, I got those in just to kind of see how that was going to look. And yeah, this looks okay. All right, guys, so I hope everybody's having a good day. It's getting awful hot out here, so I'm not sure how much longer I'm going to stay out here. It's currently 10 to 4, and my thermometer says 92 or 93 degrees, but, you know, 93 degrees with a lot of sunshine, it's really hot. So in the shade here, and I got the fan going. You can probably hear that on the mic. So, all right, we'll bring you back when I get something else done that's worth talking about. Hope everybody's having a good day. Bye.